not making pages.
Those are poems based on the story.
Okay.
They have to give a complete structure for the narrative. Well, later, basically,
when he falls asleep.
Falls asleep and he is listening to the Chithrakathi.
Mother falls asleep. That's why he doesn't have it.
And she asks her friends to interpret the dream, and they will say that it's something. something bad is going to happen. And that's how it
works. That is Parsurama's thus.
Okay. After the
before
the
Yeah.
After the beat. When he discovers that you cannot be a Brahmin if you take the power ahead that way.
Yes, you are correct. And this is the war between Arjuna and
the final.
The last final. Yeah.
Out of those names, what happens is it comes that. Do you have any question on here? This is the story of Amman. So this is that.
The story of
Amman. Arman, Duryodhana comes to Arman to ask for his sacrifice. And he will prepare my life for the day I offer. Thinking of Arman, the day that is where only the night will before the Arman sacrifice, early morning the sacrifice. So the night there will be days here, sitting in the pool and break the clay head. And it is painted at the morning of the sacrifice. It is that Arman asked for him. He wants to marry a person who Krishna marries him. And he wants to see Mahabharata. So his head is always alive seeing Mahabharata. Yeah, and finally he wants to fight the Mahabharata. So what happens is all the Nagas form his body. And he fights in the Mahabharata and he dies in the 8th day. So he dies in the 10th. He comes in like easy and the snakes are rare pieces. That's to the Duryodhana.
Measures have been taken to preserve ethics through human efforts. popular culture, discourses, theatre traditions like the Kudal, Yakshagana, Kathakali, etc. has entwined itself in our daily lives. Mahabharata as an epic has impregnated into our system. We were able to understand the global and contemporary approach to Mahabharata through Peter Brook's drama, where people from various cultural and ethnic backgrounds were able to play their roles and identify themselves with the characters in the great epics. We were inspired by Peter Brook's Mahabharata while we were exploring the different facets of Mahabharata in this via different media. We decided to merge the dying art form Chithrakathi of Maharashtra and the vibrant theatre form of Tamil Nadu, Bharatha-k-koothu, and present a series of paintings based on various characters in the Mahabharata. Poet Shankarama Subramanian has embellished our paintings with his invaluable verses. We thank Ramji Nagarajan for making things happen at Ahmedabad. Our sincere thanks to the management and staff of Hutheesing Art Gallery for their cooperation. I thank all the people present and some who have not been able to make it to the show today to make this exhibition a grand success. Thank you. Now, I request
why have we never heard of this? We we burn the sita and we see all the fervor and we're going to jump into the fire. But this is the woman we relate to. So there was something in that character that was so contemporary that somehow it cut across cultural barriers. And I think that in a time where Indian mythology is being used to repress and suppress women by political parties, all of us, both men and women, need to re-examine what these archetypical characters actually mean. We reduce them to yes, Shankar Chakra in his hands, but what does the Shankar mean? What are all the interpretations? What does the Chakra mean? When a head is cut off, what does it mean? What if somebody is talking to me about the ego and the defeat of the ego and what that meant? But how many of us get stuck on just the visual imagery of our mythology? And certainly for those of us who are interested in gender politics and in what it means to be a liberated woman or a liberated man, Draupadi becomes a very interesting set of contradictions which in fact we face on a daily basis. And therefore the statue of Draupadi, I think, becomes very important to try and peel away the stories and to go into A, the situations, but B, the psychological states that they represent. I want to congratulate you for this fantastic work and hope that someday we can work together on a performance with this so that we take it to the next stage. You have got it from the performance and the painting into painting. And perhaps we can then take this kind of painting and take it back into performance. Thank you very much.
Performers and performing artists are of every kind, writers. I think this wonderful gathering of so many different artists of various views together. And what we are celebrating here, I'm very happy to host the Art Center, is presentation of our epics and how epic they are in our daily lives as well, to various interpretations of characters that have been and that who we are as well. Because, you know, I think all of us relate to one character or the other within these major elements. And there is a war we are fighting in our daily lives, which is represented in these paintings as well. So each of these paintings do relate very much to each and every one of us individually and collectively in society. And therefore the Mahabharata is one of the most important stories of humanity from beginning and even today we can share it with you. We have it presented in this format, which is absolutely beautiful and heartwarming. I'm delighted that we are part of this movement of resurrecting our Indian classical art and bringing it to the forefront and sharing it with the people across the country and bringing to them what is the Atman culture. So I congratulate the artists for what wonderful work they have done, and I wish you all the more glory and success, and whatever this institute and center and I community can do to help that, I'll be humble if you'll allow us. Thank you.
Thank you. बहुत नॉर्मल है.
कैमरा में थोड़ा सा